This project started out with my nephew Max discovering how much fun the dirt in the flower pot is. So my brother and I were musing over what could be built to attach a screen to that flower pot to keep him out of the dirt.
I took careful measurements of the flower pot and I want to make a ring that goes around the top of it. So I laid out how my circle was going to look on a piece of plywood with a beam compass and some rulers. And I'm going to make that circle out of 8 segments, and I made a piece of wood to be the size of one of the segments, and I used that to work out how to cut these out of this thick piece of oak. I want to join the ends of these pieces together with finger joints. And for that, I want to use my Screw Advance box joint jig. To make the fingers on my finger joint a little bit wider, I actually stacked 2 thin curved skill saw blades on top of each other. And I made a test cut with that. And that test cut measures about 3.8 millimeters wide. So I want to advance the carriage per cut a little bit less than twice that. So I would want to do about 7.6 or less millimeters per cut, and on my spacing table for the box joint jig, the next lowest I've got is 7.14, so I make it a little bit of a loose joint, and for that I need 3 turns of the 24 tooth gear against the 16 tooth gear. So here's my 24 tooth gear, and that goes on my gear mount in the upper position so that it meshes against the 16 tooth gear, and just tighten that up. I'm going to cut 3 of these pieces at a time, and then position them like this so that the grain is kind of facing more into the blade, because the blade is much better at cutting like this than out of the grain. To make sure the fingers are all at a consistent position with respect to the piece of wood, I always return the carriage by turning this knob by a multiple of 3 turns, so that basically I'm staying on these increments. But to figure out where the other complementing ones need to be, I'm going to put the workpiece in the other way around. Now to cut here to complement the fingers, I put this in here and I make sure that this lines up with cutting exactly where one of the fingers is here. And then once I have the position dialed in, I just loosen this knob here back off the gear and put the handle back in the home position and tighten that up again. So now all my cuts are once again going to be with the handle right here. Those joints ended up a bit looser than I was hoping for. But first I'd cut all of these sides of the joints, and so before I cut the other halves of the joints, I put in a slightly thinner stack of blades to make these fingers a bit thicker and get that fit a little bit better. Still a bit on the loose side. So the simple solution to joints that are a bit on the loose side is glue. Lots and lots and lots of glue. And that'll fill those gaps. It just means it takes a fair bit longer to dry. Just going to move that in and out a bit just to make sure all the fingers have got thorough amounts of glue on them. While I'm still waiting for the glue to dry on these ring parts, I made a hexagonal base that's going to go underneath the flower pot. And the ring goes on the top edge, so with the ring at the top edge and the base underneath, there's going to be 25 centimeters from the base to the bottom edge of the ring. And the ring is about 5 centimeters wider than the base. So these dowels need to splay outwards a bit, and with a 25 centimeter height, that makes for a slope of 0.1, and if we take the inverse tangent of that, it's a 5.7 degrees. So these dowels will need to angle outwards by 5.7 degrees. Still waiting for that glue to be dry enough, but that's going to go on here something like so. Now that the glue is finally dry enough, I sanded it, and now I can put this together. And I need to mark 6 spots where the dowels are going to go. So I'm just going to use my base and place it on here. And I want to make sure the dowels don't end up on a joint and get this centered. And then just mark approximately where these need to go. If they're off by a few millimeters, no one will know. I was a bit nervous once I'd assembled this ring that the pot wouldn't fit inside of it, so I brought it here to do one more fitting before I glue it. And actually I have a bit of space inside, and the dowels seem to be about the right length too, so I can go ahead and finish this up. To keep Max's fingers out of the soil in the flower pot, I made this metal harbor cloth screen, and that has to be in 2 parts so we can get it around the tree. And to attach this, I actually cut the ring in halves. And after I cut it in half, I milled this groove around here with a router so that the screen can fit behind this groove when the top is attached. Screwdriver. Screwdriver? Uh-oh.
Oh.
Screwdriver. Ha ha.